dreams. Hallelujah. Amen. 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 How many of your dreams involve you, you know, going to college? Hallelujah. 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 That's a blessing. That's a blessing. You know, I'm going to start off my testimony, you know, talking about Raymond's High School. And it's been a blessing, you know, to be a part of this community and this church. Hallelujah. This is a beautiful, beautiful church. You know, I felt God, you know, as soon as I walked in the building and started praying. And it was just such a blessing and amazing. And being at Great Mills High School, being an athlete, senior year, it was really tough for me. Every day, I have somebody asking me, what college you going to? What college you going to? What college you going to? And, you know, talking with my mom and applying from different, you know, schools, it was almost like a job, you know. And God put on my heart, my first dream was to go to the University of North Carolina. If you asked me last year what college was I going to, I was saying UNC, I'm going to Chapel Hill in North Carolina. But God got a plan, hallelujah. You know, some things that we want in life may not be meant for us. You know, when, you know, that's really a hard pill to swallow when you want something so bad and, you know, God, he takes it away from you. But also at Great Mills High School, I was an outstanding athlete. You know, I ended up graduating with a 3.5 GPA. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And despite those circumstances, you would think that I would receive a scholarship, an academic scholarship from Great Mills High School. And, you know, unfortunately, that didn't happen, but, like, God got a plan. So I'm at the gym training one day, me and one of my other buddies, and I end up meeting this guy. And God, you know, he puts people in your life for a reason. So I'm at the gym one day, and I'm training this guy. He sees my game. He's like, wow, kid, you got potential. You know, so I keep training with this guy, I want to say over a course of a few months. And then he comes with some great news that I didn't even know. He was like, Raymond, I played Division I basketball. You know, I understand your dream. You know, I want to try to help you. So in that time, he ended up knowing the coach from LaSalle University. This was the first school I attended. And it's Division I, and it's in Philadelphia. So, you know, I'm geeked out. I'm happy. And I end up applying. I end up getting almost $25,000 in scholarships to go to the school. Amen. And it was a blessing because now I'm finally thinking that I'm going to be able to achieve my dream. I'm finally going to be able to play Division I basketball. I'm finally going to be able to be on television and show people, you know, how great I am and my talents and my ambitions. But, you know, God got a plan. Amen. So I get accepted. The school would cost $50,000, but they give you $25,000, you know, just for a little help. And some financial aid costs, and almost had it to around maybe $7,000 for me to keep attending just for that semester. But just to talk about the work God, you know, has brought in my life. A lot of pain that we go through is all for purpose. And just to be rejected from your dream is really tough. And God is good. So with me going to the school, I got accepted. I got my foot in the door. You know, I'm talking to the assistant coach. He says, Raymond, you know, I like your game film. You know, I really like your jump shot. You know, we could probably use you in this program, but nothing is guaranteed. I want you to come for this school for academics. You know, this is one of the top business schools on the East Coast, LaSalle University. And I want you to come to this school. If you do come for your academics, don't. You know, just don't come for basketball because it's not guaranteed. So I'm thinking, okay, I'm going to prove this guy wrong. I worked so hard all 4 years of Great Mills High School, you know, in the classroom as well as on the basketball court. And I was like, I'm going to prove this guy wrong. I'm going to prove him wrong. I'm going to prove the coaching staff wrong. I'm going to walk on the team, and I'm going to show people that I can be successful and make it. But, like, God got a plan, don't he? Amen. So, you know, August goes by. September goes by, October goes by, and I'm not a chance. I don't have a chance to try for the team. That's a tough thing. You know, when you pray for something so hard and, you know, God says, nah, that's not for you. You know, you'd be like, what, God, why you do that to me, man? Like, So now I'm sitting here, I got to make decisions, you know, 17, 18, 19 years old, asking somebody what they want to do for the rest of their life is a really hard thing. And I can tell that's probably a testimony for a lot of you adults. You weren't the same person you were when you were 17, 18, 19 years old, you know. So God, you know, he really, right now, he's molding me and crafting me to the person that he wants me to be. So not being able to try out for LaSalle University, you know, I had some decisions to make. The school was awesome. The academics, the curriculum was amazing. I learned a lot of business classes. I learned marketing classes. That's my major. And I learned a lot of great things at that school, but, you know, I just wasn't getting total fulfillment. So that November, God got a plan, don't he? That November, I end up emailing 70 different college coaches from Delaware to New Jersey to Maryland, everywhere. I end up even 70 college coaches, and only maybe 9 of them replied back to me. And that's a tough thing. Like, every day I was in the library emailing them. And there's this one school that I really didn't want to go to, Penn State Harrisburg, that God just let on my heart to just contact them. So I end up calling them. I emailed them, having my dream at that one school, and God, you know, granted me another opportunity at another school was amazing. And for that winter break, I ended up coming home. I was home for maybe about a week. I enjoyed Christmas with my mom. And that same week, I ended up getting accepted into Penn State. And also, this is Harrisburg University, one of their branches. I ended up getting accepted into the Penn State branch. And then I end up, you know, taking a trip out there. My mom, his friend, and we end up setting up things, and I'm living my dream. And then January 3rd of this year, we end up playing St. Mary's College, which was a blessing. Hallelujah. So now, one of my dreams, now I'm able to show the people that it's possible to be successful. And now I'm able to show them that if you work hard for something, you know, God will supply all your needs. And people may ask, so why didn't you go to this school in the first place? You know, why didn't you just go to Penn State in the first place? And the footsteps of a righteous man is ordered by the Lord. So it was meant for me to learn the things that I was supposed to learn at LaSalle University. I was supposed to go through that to get to Penn State Harrisburg. So now I'm taking it as a blessing, amen? Taking it as a blessing. So then this course of living my dream, I'm finally playing college basketball. On my website, you can see pictures. I'm finally playing college basketball. I'm finally living my dream. But, you know, the devil's busy. Hallelujah. Every knee shall bow. Hallelujah. So, you know, that week of February 13th, I get a call from my coach. He says, Raymond, I need you in my office as soon as possible. You know, we need to talk about some things. I said, all right, no coach, no problem. Then finally get there, sit down, talk with him. He said, Raymond, I need you to go down to the bursar's office. And the bursar's office, for you who don't know, is the billing office for your school. They say, Raymond, this is your second payment. You know, you missed the first one. You need $13,000. And I'm like, first, you know, after he told me that, he was like, I need you to go down there tomorrow. And he was like, there's maybe something I can do for you. I want you to write a letter. And I want you to give it to me. I know some people. I can probably help you out. So I'm saying, okay, no problem. God got it. I'm going to keep praying on it. So that whole night, you know, I just broke down. You know, I was in my room. I was like, how in the world am I going to get this paid for? How am I going to be able to live my dreams? But, you know, God, he got a plan. So I called my mom's. So I called my mom, and she says, Raymond, whatever you want to do, she said, Raymond, I'm not educated enough to tell you exactly what you need to do. But whatever you want to do, I have your support. I got your back. I was like, okay, no problem, Mom. I ended up calling one of my good friends, and he ended up giving me some great advice. And I was like, I got to make a plan. I got to see how I can get my community, see how I can get, you know, my state, my country, see how I can get my people together to help support me on this journey and this dream. And that's where you see Team Raymond. This is where it comes about. Because the word Raymond is not just built on one letter. And me, Raymond Mcleod, I'm not just built by me. You know, I have God, I have my mother, I have my church family, I have my community. I have people together supporting me and guiding me through this. And as my mom says, it takes a village to raise a child. She can't do it all on her own. So this is a blessing to be up here to share my testimony. Amen. So I go to the Bershaw's office, right? And I'm talking to the lady. She says, I owe $13,000. And then, you know, I'm scrambling the whole day. That day, surprisingly, somehow I end up getting contact with the mayor, James Curry, of the area. And it was Monday, and the money was due by that Thursday. And I'm talking to him. He's like, Raymond, I really respect you. You know, I'm proud of you that you reached out to me, but it's too close of a gap. I can't, you know, help you that fast. So the mayor of the town ended up calling Penn State Harrisburg admissions office, and he was like, man, you better go right back down there and see if any help you can get. So I get off the phone with him, and then I walk down there, and then I talk to him, and they say, Raymond, so what's your plan? So my plan, Team Raymond, this I want to get my community together to help support me on this journey for college and for success. And I believe, you know, not just helping, supporting me, but I believe that if this is a success, amen, that I can have hundreds of kids, you know, the ones that are following behind greatness, the ones that, you know, want to make something out of their life, be able to follow the same footsteps as this. And it only takes one. And it only takes one, because I believe that if we all get together as a community, as one body, as one mind, to be able to help support our young black youth, we have so many accounts with a lot of different negative things going on in the community. We hear more than we hear the positive. We hear more than we hear the positive. And I believe if us as a community can support the people that are pushing for positive, we can all push each other. As I said, the name of Raymond is not just one letter. It's built of many letters. You know, so as we push together as one body, as one team, you know, to try to help me to get back to where I can get to, I believe that we can turn this into a brand. We can turn Team Raymond into something that, you know, kids can wear and, you know, people can appreciate and be proud of, you know. And I believe that this can change lives, because there's going to be another kid some other day, 5 years from now, that's going to go through the same situation that I'm going through. You know, and I know there's people before that have gone through this same situation and then have stirred their paths off with different minds and saying, oh, since I don't have the money, well, I guess I'm going to have to do this to get some money. You know, since I can't go to college, since my mom, you know, can't afford it, then I'm going to have to do this. No, if we stand righteous in God, you know, if we believe that if we can do this together and keep him first, all things can be done. And I believe that I will be able to get back in college, and I believe that it will be paid for, because I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. Amen? And amen? And, you know, the month of March, I was talking about the process, right? And God, you know, in different seasons, it's all about a transition. And God, he will put you through a process so when you get your blessing, you can be able to keep it. Amen? And throughout all the people in this room that have a dream, that have a goal, that have something, God has already created you that person that you were supposed to be. You are a seed, and you already planted the person that you are supposed to be. And God, he's rooting you in this word, in this body, to be able to grow, and to be able to grow as a tree, to be able to blossom and be able to be the person that you ought to be. So maybe it wasn't meant for me to go to that Division I school. Maybe it was meant for me to be up here and inspire a young man to be successful and to grind and work hard. Maybe it was meant for me to be up on this stage here today, because without the things that God put me through, without that struggle, without that trial and tribulation, yes, it was nice when, you know, my mother couldn't afford it. And yes, it was nice we eating soup for the whole week, just blessed, praise, hallelujah. You know, it was nice when we have peanut butter, no jelly in the cabinet. I'm been there. I'm going through that now. You know, but God, when you have God in it, you know, the footsteps of a righteous man is ordered by the Lord. And for me to be up here today is just a blessing, and it's a testimony of what positiveness can come out of this community. We hear so much about, you know, this one going to jail. No, let's go to college today, Lord Jesus. Let's go to church today, Lord Jesus. Let's get this word and be anointed in the right place, Lord God. And I believe this can help impact and empower kids all over the world. And this is just me starting out as a 19-year-old chief executive officer, if you don't know, CEO of my own company at 19, of my own brand that I believe that one day will be able to blossom among millions, to be able to help push kids to get to college, to be able to push kids to go to school. This is a dream that I have manifested in me. You know, today I was thinking about, you know, how am I going to script this? But no, it's all coming from the heart. You know, God has put this testimony in my heart to be able to impact other lives in the future. And for the kids that look up to me, I pray that God will continue to use me. This is not me. This is not the old Raymond Mcleod. This is new. You know, all things is working for, you know, his good. And every man, hallelujah, is a new creature. Hallelujah. And as you see the great 32T. The lady asked me, so what does the T stand for? I was talking to one wise man, and he said, you have to define who you are. And if you look at it, my number is 32, and the E in the 32 backwards is ES. So it says the greatest. So I want to be the greatest Raymond Mcleod I can be. Hallelujah. I want to be the greatest man that I can be through him working through me. You know, why not define yourself as something great? You of God, right? So let's get other kids in the future to be able to have this same experience, this same community coming together, Father God. Hallelujah. And I believe that it can be seen as a brand that other kids will be able to manifest in the same light. And also through my website, you know, I have a few slides up on my website. And if you go to it, it's thegreat32.weebly.com. I have been promoting it on Twitter and Instagram and different things. And also, God has blessed me. Last Sunday, I was able to get on the radio station with Travis Thomas and be able to, you know, first broadcast it, you know, to the world and stuff. But also, there's a tab on it that says, you can go to the tab. Hallelujah. The Great 32. If you read this tab, this basically has an overview of my story. And if you take a chance to, you know, go home, read it, show your coworkers, you know, show your kids. And also the next tab is the grind. You know, my vision is I want people to actually see what I'm going through, you know, each and every day, as far as my basketball workouts and my training. So I want to be able to post videos and show people, you know, that they can say, okay, I can work on this if you're a basketball player. Or, you know, how's Raymond Mcleod doing? You can check out the grind post. And the videos and stuff will be coming soon. And also the blessing, because, you know, God, you know, he's using me right now to help and inspire others. So right now, on the blessing webpage, I have motivational quotes that I have all over my wall, and I'm taking each and every one of them and putting them on the blessing page to help and encourage others to reach for success. Amen. One more. And also, Team Raymond, if you want to email me, you know, if you want to donate or anything, you know, this is my GoFundMe account. And also, this is my email. So, you know, God is good. One, you know, have patience and wait on the Lord, because some things in life that don't come on your time, it would always be right on time. Amen. Have patience. And two, I want you to have faith. Have faith in the Lord, because you may not see it. You may not see your dream. You may not see your vision. You may not see it at that moment, but God, he's working and molding you to create you to the person that you're supposed to be. You know, and last, I want you to trust in him. Trust in him every single day of your life, because without trust in him, you know, you lose faith. You know, so that's what I want to leave you with. I want you to, you know, trust in God, you know, stay focused. And your dreams, I pray that they manifest. You know, this right here is just a vision and just a dream. But, you know, each and every kid in here today, if you have a dream, you know, I want God to definitely work with you and use you. Because you never know when that day when you're helping somebody else. I pray that this vision will be able to encourage the youth, encourage somebody else, encourage another kid in the same footsteps as me in a few years to potentially do great things in this community. Amen. And I'm done. I thank you for having me today. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Amen. Hallelujah.